Welcome to the video tutorial on how to configure Aruba access points. From there you create a stable, seamless wireless network. These are the two Aruba access points I used in this example. From there you can create a wireless network with a larger number of access points. I marked the access points as 1 and 2 respectively. I connect access point 1 to my network using an Ethernet cable. The DHCP server assigns the access point an IP address. So on a Windows computer I use an IP address scanning software to find the IP address of access point 1. After finding the IP address, I open any browser to access the Aruba access point using the IP address I just found. The default username is admin. The default password is the serial number of the Aruba access point. You find that password on the label affixed to the device. After logging in for the first time using your serial number, you will be asked to create a new administrative password. From now on, you use this admin password to log into the Aruba access point. By default, the first Aruba access point is identified as master. All settings on this Aruba access point will be synchronized to access points in your network. Access point 1 becomes a controller for your wireless network system. On access point 1, I created a new wireless network. In addition to setting the wireless network name and wireless network password, you enable fast roaming. Fast roaming makes your wireless network seamless and stable. When using fast roaming, you set up an ID so that access points can create links with each other. Devices connected to the wireless network using Aruba access points always maintain a seamless and stable connection. That's why you enabled fast roaming on Aruba. Above are the configuration steps on access point 1. It is identified as the master device and the access points will synchronize configuration from access point 1. I connect access point 2 to my network using an Ethernet cable. If you have more than 2 access points, the next access points will automatically be configured with the master access point. The management system is integrated on the access points and it marks the master access point with a star. So what if the master access point is broken or lost connection to your network system? Don't worry too much, Aruba access points will automatically elect a new master. For example, in this case, if I disconnect access point 1, access point 2 will be selected as the new master. Good luck!